Dun 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 dun. Roar. Wait, do sharks say roar? Welcome to the sunny shores where your dinner awaits. In this fast-paced, take that tile lane game, you are a shark, a hungry shark, and you are not alone in these shallow waters. Your shark buddies are all hungry too, and you must battle back and forth for food until you have filled your gut and taken your rightful place as the shark king. Before we dive in, I want to take a moment to say this is a sponsored video by the publisher Loudcats. So I'll be doing an overview of the game so you can get a feel for it and decide if it's right for you. The game comes with six sharks for you to commune with. Choose your shark. Become the shark. Feel the shark. From henceforth, I shall now be known as Shadow. Dun it, dun it. Now there are a number of tiles in this game. Place all those tiles in the box face down. This becomes your drawing pool. We'll dip our fins in here in just a moment. It's time to take your place in the water. Roll the dice and place your shark's head on the corresponding water space. All that matters here is where you place the head, so feel free to orient yourself however it best suits you. You are now ready to start the feeding frenzy. The gameplay is simple. You are going to restore the crates along the top of the board, select one, play one if you so choose, and then move your shark. Wait, I thought you said feeding frenzy. Ah yes, my young Sharkawan, that all comes with the tiles. Let's look at those now. There are 100 tiles in your drawing pool. Well, technically 95, since we need to put 5 of these onto the crates first. If any of them are food, well, they need to immediately head to the water. Food are tiles that show wildlife, tourists, locals, whatever, we're hungry. And as long as you see this little fishy in the upper left, you know these tiles are food. We place these just like we place ourselves in the water. We roll and then place. If there is a shark head in that space, chomp, they put the food into their gut locker. The gut locker is the place where we hold all the tiles we collect to use or eat later. You can't eat until you're the shark king, and you can't be the shark king until you collect 50 points worth of food. Now, if you like to play with your food, each tile is covered in the rulebook for you to learn more about it. Like Josh the Jawbreaker. I'll be honest, Josh has had a hard life. His mate left him for a Galapagos tortoise. One his fin is shorter than the other, and he really overextended his credit on a shell he couldn't afford. That lone crab rides his back, literally, and hounds him for his sand dollar payments. For food, this is just for fun. For other tiles, it is both for fun and so you know how to use it to gain victory over your fellow sharks. The rulebook will also tell you how many of each tile is in the game. Some of the more common tiles, other than food, are treasure chests, where you get to steal from another shark's gut locker, barf, where you randomly choose then relocate a tile from another shark's gut locker, chum bucket, which draws sharks in, the fishing boat, which keeps sharks at a distance, islands, which can block shark movement, mines, to blow stuff up, whirlpools, to relocate sharks, and shark repellent, which pushes sharks to the very edges of the board. Remember when I said, take that? You'll want to use these tiles strategically as you choose them. You do not have to play the tile you just chose from the crate. You can hold on to it for later strategery. The last action you take on your turn is to move. You roll the d4, then you move. If you place an island this turn, you get +1 movement. And just like when we place our shark, the head is what matters. Move the head the appropriate amount of spaces. No diagonals, that's cheating. And that is the end of your turn. Inevitably or intentionally, such as with the chum bucket or movement, sharks may end up in the same place. When this happens, fight. Simply roll the dice. Whoever comes out with the higher roll wins. Winner blind pulls a tile from the loser's gut locker and places it in their own. When there are multiple sharks, winner chooses one to take a tile from and then relocates the others to any free space. There are optional power-ups you can add to the game which give you bonus fight, movement, and other fun abilities, and the Kickstarter will have some stretch goals that add even more tiles to the game, such as an octopus who hates everyone racing by and disturbing his garden. You'll put him on one of your opponents in order to slow them down. Or food that fights back like Marvin, the jerk of the sea. As well as two new sharks. Well, one shark and one competitive dolphin. Titans! Each game will vary from the luck of the draw combined with your strategic choices. If you like Take That with a bit of humor, the rulebook is hilarious, and fun, vibrant art, then this game might be for you. I've included a link in the description where you can learn more about the game. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. With that, I'm off to get a bite. Shadow!
Congratulations, you got to the end of one of our videos. Now, if you want more practice, just click on the video over here. It's another video. You might not have seen it yet, so click on it. If you don't want to do that, at least click on the subscription button below. That always helps us. And if you want notifications, please ring that bell.